class 9, as we have completed the chapter Reach for the Top, the first part, that is Santosh Yadav. Okay, so now today we are going to discuss it, but before that let us have a short revision of what we have read in the chapter. Anybody is having difficulty? If you have the difficulty, you can ask me. Now for this chapter, so what this chapter is about, the chapter is about Santosh Yadav, who has scaled Mount Everest twice. Okay, who has scaled Mount Everest twice. She has scaled it for the first time in 1992. Okay, when she has joined the mountaineers who are going to the Aravali Hills, and later on the second time when she has climbed it. It was with the Indianapolis Women Expedition. And it was almost after 1 year that she has undertaken this second journey to Mount Everest, right? And if we talk about the background of Santosh Yadav, then where did she belong? She belonged to a Haryanvi background. She was born in Rewari district. Of which village it is? Jonyavas village. And what kind of atmosphere was prevailing in the house or in her family? It was conservative. Okay, though they were affluent landowners, but they were, as a tradition of the family prevailed, or according to the tradition of the family, the children, they have to study in the village school only, right? And like, but she was a rebel since childhood. She knew that whatever she is doing is rational, and she knew that if she is taking any rational decision, she need not to change, but others have to change their path or decision. So she's not conforming to the rules of the society or to the rules and regulations of the society, as other girls, they were wearing traditional dresses. She was wearing shorts. Okay, and when she has grown up till the age of 16 years, she was forced to get married, but she was not at all ready to get married. So what she earlier she was protesting, but in her own way. But she spoke when the right time arrived. And when was that right time? It was when she was at the age of 16 years. When she was at the, please close the books and don't copy the questions from some other book. And when she has attained the age of 16 years. Okay, so when she has reached to the age of 16 years, then what happened? Yes, she presented or she protested against her schooling, and she asked her parents that she wanted to study in Delhi. But when, and her parents also, they forced her to get married. Okay, but she refused plainly that she won't get married until and unless she would be equipped with adequate and proper education. And for that purpose, she wanted to enroll herself in the Delhi school, for which her parents were not at all ready. Okay, so for that, what happened? She enrolled herself secretly in the Delhi school, and also told her parents that if they would not pay her fee, then she would be earning by doing a part-time job. Okay, by doing a part-time job, right? Very good. So then afterwards, what happened after completing her school education? She got admission in Maharani College in Jaipur. Okay, and where she was living? She was living in Kasturba Hostel. Okay, so that was actually the turning point in her life, because her one of her window, it was facing the Aravali Hills. And daily she used to see number of people climbing up the hills. She thought that those were the village people who were climbing up, who were going up. And finally, what happened? One day she decided herself to talk to them. And when she presented her desire that she wanted to climb Mount Everest along with them, as they were not village people, they were actually mountaineers who were climbing Aravali Hills, and they were practicing there. And what they did, they answered in affirmative. And since then, she grew in her life. And after that, what happened after completing her college education? She got admission in Nehru Institute of Mountaineering in Uttarakashi. So after getting admission there, then what happened? Yes, but she was determined also to achieve her goal. She was so filled with the feeling of perseverance that she wanted to take over the job, fulfill the job what she has undertaken. Then afterwards, as her college exams, they are going to be over by 19, okay, because of some reason they were being delayed, and later on her training would start at 21. So she had just one day with her, but what she decided not to go to her parents, but she has gone to Uttarakashi Nehru Institute, and for which she has written an apology letter to her father, in which she has mentioned her incapability to come to the village and meet them. So after that, when she has joined, she was now getting professional skills for mountaineering. And after getting professional skills for mountaineering, then what is happening? She has mastered her skills gradually. Okay. She's getting, just a moment, please. Yes, ma'am, please.
Anybody telling why is
She has mastered her skills in mountaineering gradually, and for that she is developing various qualities like physical endurance, perseverance, and mental toughness. These are the qualities which are responsible for her success in the field of mountaineering, right? Then afterwards, what kind of relationship she was sharing with her juniors as well as fellow climbers, they were quite impressed of her. Which qualities? Climbing skills, mental toughness, and physical strength. And what her seniors, they are impressed? And her readiness to help others. Yes, that her desire to work together, her physical fitness as well as her mental toughness. Okay. So after that, in 1992, she has scaled Mount Everest, and she has came out to be the first youngest woman of India who has climbed Mount Everest. Okay. Then afterwards. Yes, she tried to help. She tried to help her fellow climbers also, but for one, she tried to save his life, but she was unsuccessful in saving his life. But she has saved the life of Mohan Singh. Right, Mohan Singh, how she has saved? By sharing her oxygen cylinder with him. Okay, so later on after that, after 1 year, 12 months has been elapsed or passed when she was asked by the Indianapolis Women Expedition to join them to climb Mount Everest. Okay, and she took the advantage of the opportunity, and it was for the second time that she has scaled Mount Everest. Right, very good. So after that, so when she was interviewed and asked what kind of feelings she had when she scaled Mount Everest, so what was her answer? She said that she was not able to understand the enormity of the situation, that how great this occasion was. She was not feeling that it was reality. She was just feeling that it is a dream come true. Okay, so she was not able to adapt to understand the enormity of the situation. But when she unfurled the Indian flag at the top or at the summit of the mountain, that was a kind of feeling which she explained that is indescribable. Okay, so then what she said? Yes, it was really a spiritual moment for her. Okay, and she felt proud as an Indian. Moreover, another great quality, along with her strength, along with her climbing skills, along with her determination, is another quality that she was a fervent environmentalist. What is the meaning of fervent? Concerned and sincere. She was a fervent environmentalist. What is the example given here? That while coming back from, she collected how much? 500 kilograms of garbage from the Himalaya. See, it is really very difficult to climb the mountain, and so much weight is there on their backs. and it is very difficult to walk with that weight, and carrying some extra burden is of course a difficult job. Okay, so like here I'm teaching you this chapter, that is of Santosh Yadav, who is a mountain climber. And in 8th class also the same chapter, almost the same one, in which HPS Aluwalia, Major HPS Aluwalia, he has climbed Mount Everest. Okay, so that was more deeper chapter than this. Okay, there the information is given, but that means every line it holds a meaning. He said, means in that chapter, someone is interviewing him and he has been asked that why you have climbed mountains. He said, like we breathe. Okay, like we breathe, we don't have any answer to it. To some of the questions, there are no answers. Okay, so mountains, they are always fascinating me. Okay, so this is, I'm telling you in the simple language, but it is quite impressive, as well as you can say twisted language there has been explained. Okay, sometimes the level of difficulty varies in various classes. Okay, so that was also really very interesting chapter. But whatever, I think that whatever climber is there, he is always showing this skill of determination. This is the reason that why they have undertaken this job to climb Mount Everest. Okay, it's not an easy job. And you know that why that Indianapolis women expedition, they have asked her to join them, because they want a skillful person as well as an experienced person with them, for whose help they can seek. Okay, whose help they can seek, so that he can share his her experiences and can tell them, this is the better way, we can do it in this way, this is the better way, and we can follow that way. Okay, so it is because of this reason, right? So let us start the question answers, discussion of question answers. So the first question is, why was the holy man who gave Santosh mother his blessings surprised? Yes, Ramni?
The holy man had assumed that Santosh mother wanted a son as the part of the society she belonged to regarded with a son as a blessing. However, he was surprised when the unborn child's grandmother told him that they didn't want a son.
Okay, right. So as the tradition of the society prevails, okay, that the birth of a son is considered to be auspicious in the family. So when Santosh's grandmother, she asked for a blessing, or her mother, she asked for a blessing for a baby girl, the holy man was surprised. Okay, as no one has ever asked him to give a blessing for a baby girl. So this was the reason. Okay. So next question is, give an example. What are you writing, Anand? Kya naam hai Ayan? Close it down, please, book. Yes, one thing I would like to remind you is that you have to make an index. Don't forget to make an index before starting the notebook. Make an index, start with the new notebook for term 2, which will include your PT3 as well as the final exams, right? Okay, all the chapters to be included in here. Don't overlook the writing skills. Okay, as I'm always looking in the notebooks, format is written, then writing skill is not there. Okay, so don't try to do that. This is very much important. And after that, I'm going to check the notebooks in class. Physical notebooks, which I would like to say concrete form of notebooks. Okay, what is concrete and abstract? You know, abstract and concrete, they are opposites to each other. Abstract means which we cannot touch. Which we cannot touch, but one can feel. Okay, and concrete is which we can touch. Okay, right. So I'm going to check those notebooks. So get ready for these. Okay, side by side, you have to complete your chapters, and no delay in the notebooks. Right, no delay in the work. And moreover, you have your internal assessment activities also, that will be announced shortly to you all. And for that, you have to prepare. Notebook also carries marks, activity, and you will also have your listening and speaking skills. Okay, that is very much important. Okay. So the next question is, give an example to show that even as a young girl, Santosh was not ready to accept anything unreasonable. Yes, Archita. Very good. 1 minute. Let me get the mic here. Now speak. You can come here. Yes, speak the answer.
very beginning lived life on her own terms. She was not content with the traditional way of life and was not ready to accept anything unreasonable. One example which proves that is that Santosh, unlike other girls who wore traditional dresses, she preferred wearing Indian shorts.
So this is one of the examples that she has given. Yes, of course, Santosh was not at all conforming to the prevalent rules of the society. Okay, she, whatever she was doing, she thought it to be, she has a reason for that. She thought it rationally. Okay, and for that purpose, what she wanted, she knew that if she is choosing a right path, then ultimately others have to change, but not she has to change. And for that, she is not conforming to the prevalent rules. So first example was that all the girls were wearing traditional dresses, and what she was wearing only shorts. And the second example given in the chapter is that yes, when she attained the age of 16, she was forced to get married, but she denied and asked her parents that if she would not get proper education, she would not marry ever in her life. Next question is, why was Santosh sent to the local school? What was the reason? Yes, Panika, you can come here so that I can present the mic to you. Yes, speak, answer.
Santosh parents were very affluent landowners who could afford to send their children to the best schools. But as it was the tradition, as it was the custom in the family, so Santosh had to make do with the local village school. So she decided to fight the system in her own quiet way when the right moment arrived.
Yes. So what was the answer to that? Good, Panika. Right answer given by you. That where Santosh was always eager to go to school in Delhi. But as the family, according to the family tradition, all the children has to study in the local village school. Although she belonged to a family of affluent landowners, but they could afford them to send to the one of the best schools even in the capital of the country, that is Delhi. But they were forced to study according to the tradition of the family in the local village school, and this is why Santosh, she studied there only. Okay. Next question is, whom did she leave home? Sorry, when did she leave home for Delhi and why? Yes. Arsh?
Lavina. At the age of 16, Santosh was also under pressure from her parents for marriage. She threatened her parents that she would never marry if she did not get a proper education. She left home and got herself enrolled in a school in Delhi. When her parents refused to pay for her education, she informed them of her plans to earn money by working part-time to pay her school fees.
So right answer, when did she leave home for Delhi? When she has attained the age of 16 years and it was the time to get married according to the tradition prevalent there. Okay, so for that, what she said, that she was not ready to get married and she enrolled herself secretly to one of the schools in Delhi. And she has, when she has presented the fact in front of her parents and displayed them the reality that she is going to study there and they have to pay her fee, and the parents, they denied of this service, and ultimately what she did, she told them she would earn the money by doing a part-time job. And this was the moment when she has left her home for Delhi. It means at the age of 16 years. Right. Next question. Why did Santosh's parents agree to pay for her schooling in Delhi? And what mental qualities of Santosh are brought into light by the incident? Okay, Arshpreet will speak.
Santosh's parents agreed to pay for her schooling in Delhi because she told them that she planned to work hard part-time in order to pay her fees. They realized that their daughter was independent, had a strong willpower and firm self-belief. She could take her decisions and also stand by them.
What qualities are brought into light? That she was, speak one please. complete trust in her thinking, right? Mentally tough, okay? Strong-headed, okay, right? Okay? So, what is the meaning of egghead? Egg-headed? Intelligent one. Okay, it's not like that one has a big brain, okay? It's intelligent. So, why did Santosh's parents agree to pay for her schooling in Delhi? So, why they agreed? Yes, because she has started doing part-time job and that was not acceptable to her parents, and they were quite affluent. And this is the reason they did not agree. And Weber, she did not, okay, although she was ready to earn money by doing a part-time job, this shows her quality that she was mentally tough, has rational thinking and determined, okay, as well as, okay, right, hardworking, of course, right. Next set of questions are, how did Santosh begin to climb mountains? Yes, Eva can tell. Yes, Eva.
When Santosh was in Maharani College, she lived in Kastuba Hostel, which were near Aravali Hills. She used to watch villagers from her room, and she decided to check which were going up the hills and suddenly vanish after a while. Then she decided to check it out herself, and she found a few mountaineers, and she asked to join them. That was the turning point of her life, and then she started mountaining. After that, she got enrolled in a course at Utkarshi Nehru Institute of Mountaineering.
So thank you, Eva. So when she began to climb mountains when she has joined Maharani College of Education in Jaipur, and while living in Kasturba Hostel, where one of the window it was facing Aravali Hills. She noticed that some of the people, they were climbing daily up the mountains. She was fascinated to see and thought that those were actually the village people. But one day she has checked herself, and what she has noticed that they were not actually village people, but they were mountaineers. That they were the mountaineers who were climbing the Aravali Hills. Okay, and then she has presented her desire to climb along with them, and this was the start of her journey of climbing to the mountains. Right. So next one is, what incidents during the Everest expedition show Santosh's concern for her teammates? Okay, Dia.
Santosh's concern for others and desire to work with them found a special place in the hearts of her fellow climbers. This can be proved with the following example. During the 1992 Everest mission, Santosh Yadav provided special care to a climber who lay dying at the South Pole, but she was unfortunately not successful in saving him. However, she managed to save another climber, Mohan Singh, who would have met with the same fate if she not shared her oxygen with him.
So absolutely right answer she has given, that she was quite concerned towards the condition or towards her fellow climbers. And this was one of the quality that is always being admired by her fellow climbers. Okay, so while climbing South Col or while reaching at the site of South Col, she tried to save the life of one of the fellow climber. But although she was unsuccessful in doing so, later on she has shared her oxygen cylinder with one of the other climbers named Mohan Singh, and she was quite successful in saving his life. And this means that she is always concerned towards the plight as well as towards the betterment of her fellow climbers. Right. Next is, what shows her concern for the environment? This we have read. What shows her concern for the environment? That she was very much concerned towards environment. She was a fervent environmentalist, okay? She was a fervent environmentalist, and for that, While coming back from, she has collected 500 kilograms of garbage. Very good, very good. Next is, how does she describe her feelings at the summit of the Everest? Now you people will speak. Yes, you can speak your name. Okay.
Santosh Yadav, while standing on the top of the ground, or top of the world, was overwhelmed with emotions of patriotism. She felt proud as an Indian when she unfurled the tricolor on Mount Everest. She was so happy that she experienced a spiritual bliss. She found it hard to articulate her feelings.
Let me explain also that when she reached Mount Everest, she was not able to accept the enormity of the situation because it was just like a dream come true. She was not able to understand that what has happened or what has been happening in front of her was actually the reality or not. And for that, when she unfurled the Indian flag at the top or at the summit of the mountain, she explained that the feelings were really indescribable. And that was really a spiritual moment for her that was filled with contentment, satisfaction, and patriotism. As she has said that she felt proud to be an Indian when she reached the summit of the mountain. Okay? And she unfurled the Indian flag also, right? So that's all for today. One question is left. Okay, speak the question, please. Santosh Yadav got into the record books both times she scaled Mount Everest. Yes, why she got? So let me explain it hurriedly because the time is going to be over. So for the first time when she scaled Mount Everest in 1992, she got her name enlisted in the world records. It's because she is one of the youngest women, only merely at the age of 20 years. Okay. She has scaled Mount Everest. And when the second time she scaled Mount Everest along with the Indianapolis expedition of women, she was again enlisted or she was again, her name was written in the record books because she is the only woman who has scaled Mount Everest twice. Okay. So I hope that each and every fact is quite clear to you. Okay. After reading the next part, that is Maria Sharapova, we will discuss extra questions of the chapter 2. So that's all for today. If you have any difficulty, now you can ask me.